Why does your friend have such a hard time figuring out their personality type? Round and round they go, and when they do start to narrow down their type, they're always picking some totally far from themselves type, and everyone around them knows it, but why can't they see it? The biggest thing that we continue to see that people are really underestimating is this whole savior demon thing. The biggest thing we continually see is this underestimation of saviors versus demons. You are addicted. For example, go watch some of these reality shows where they have people that are in addiction with drugs and alcohol and stuff like that. And don't look at them. Don't look at the drug addicted people. Look at the little healthcare practitioners that come to help them. That is the psycho drug addict I'd like you to look at. Look at this person that goes to save these people that are coming in with their saviors and taking control of these people that are in need and saying, oh, you're addicted to drugs and you're addicted to alcohol. What you need to do is follow what I've been addicted to my whole life, which is my saviors. My saviors are here to save you. They're addicted to their saviors. We're all the same. We are all on crack, addicted to our saviors. And most people don't even realize it. Who's the person that you respect the most? The person who is a drug addict, an alcoholic, and denies it? Or the person who's a drug addict and an alcoholic and admits it, right? So this is the best case scenario, is to realize that you are a drug addicted psycho to your saviors. And again, look at everyone in your life. Look at your teachers. Look at your principal. Look at your parents. Look at your friends. On crack, addicted to what feels good to them, what looks good to them. If they're controlling, you need to get more control in your life. If they're chaotic, you need to get more chaos in your life. If they're selfish, you need to be more selfish. That's what everybody's telling you. So the game here is to really realize we are psycho, drug addicted idiots to our saviors, and it's about finding where that is. For example, like if I'm going through life thinking that I'm not a narcissist, that I'm not selfish, that I'm not belligerent, that I'm not a know-it-all, that I'm not a chubby fuckface, then I'm pretty self-delusional because I'm addicted to that behavior. And I've been addicted to that behavior my whole entire life. If we ever get a chance to talk to my parents, they're gonna tell you, no, this guy's been an asshole his whole fucking life. And I can try and hide it on YouTube and play a funny guy and a nice guy and all this, but ain't nobody buying it. You can still see, wow, this guy's probably a real giant asshole in real life. Yeah. The thing that happened to me is years ago, I woke up to, I'm gonna stop denying that. I'm gonna stop trying to hide that. When people say I'm a controlling, know-it-all, narcissist asshole, I'm gonna stop saying no, you, and shoving that away. I'm like, all right, that's the 50th person that have said that. I need to just kind of take that in a little bit and really look at that and accept that. And then from there, can start to own it, can start to work on it, can start to calm it down. So this is the setting that people are skipping over when they're going to type themselves. The controlling person is so addicted to being controlling, all they can think about is that they're free going and that they're a gatherer. Because they want to be a gatherer. They don't want to be a controlling asshole. So if you have a personality test or you tell them, hey, controlling IJ asshole, you're a controlling IJ asshole, what are they going to tell you? They're going to tell you, no, I'm not, right? Because they're going to come from a position of, I don't want to be. I'm lying to myself. I don't want to be an alcoholic. I just drink every once in a while, right? So people are going to be reporting what they want to be. And what they want to be is their demons. Which is, again, consistently why we see people typing themselves almost upside down. So the lead sensory person is going to argue with you forever that they have intuition first. And the thinker is going to argue with you forever that they have feeling first. The IP is going to tell you they're an EJ. The EP is going to tell you they're an IJ. Round and round, everybody goddamn goes. It's the difference we see is when people come to us, they've gone through some stuff, where they're at a very humble self-awareness state. To where if you told them, hey, you're a drug-addicted piece of shit asshole and everybody fucking hates you, they'd be like, yeah, I know. It's true. What can I do from here? And that's a person that can now start to see themselves fully. So the saviors and the demons, your savior functions are what you are addicted to. You cannot stop doing them. They are ruining your life. For example, if you are addicted to control, you cannot have a balanced life gathering. You cannot be open-minded. You cannot learn. You cannot be easygoing. You cannot be spontaneous. Why? Because every time you go and try and do that, every time you want to do that, every time you want to be more balanced, your addiction, your animalistic body addiction to control comes in and knocks that over. Let's say the extremely extroverted person, they want to be this deep, inner world introverted person. That's how they're striving to be that. They think they're that. They want to be that. But why can't they actually do it in reality? Not according to them, according to their friends, according to their family, according to everyone around them. They can't be this deep introverted person because every time they have to go spend 20 minutes alone focusing, internally organizing. They get distracted. They jump up. They go do all this crazy shit. They do extroverted stuff. They don't process. They don't download. They're not putting in their introverts, but they want to, and that's where they'll fight you. So it's getting honest with yourself of not what do you want to do. Of course, we all want to be the opposite. We all want to be balanced. We all want to be our demons. But what are you actually doing? And then looking at these saviors as the enemy, looking at these saviors as a drug addiction, that I am addicted to helping others, therefore I'm not helping myself. I'm addicted to controlling, therefore I'm not gathering. I'm addicted to gathering, therefore I'm not controlling. And really realizing that addiction and seeing that addiction, now you can start to see yourself a little bit more and have a much better idea what type you are.